just a warning to any vegetarians, but these pork chops deserve a movie. But we also have fresh cherry tomatoes right out of the garden. Stay tuned. Step one.
Step one, grease your meat. I like olive oil. Very lightly. Olives oil. Excuse my fingers, because I'm going to wash my hands in a minute anyway. And we're going to keep the olives oil available for later. Because we might want a little more, but not too much. Okay, step two.
Okay, a big pile of freshly ground black pepper. And some salt. Ooh, lots of that. Don't worry, that's a big piece of meat. That's gonna help it make it really tender. Now I'm gonna flip it over, same thing, other side, and just let it set. In my previous video, somebody was bitching me out about my tongs. I have every freaking tool for everything known to man. Problem with these is they're nice and long, but they got no grabby grab. Like, so this big chop, when I grab it with these stupid things, it's like, nah, no good. See? That's the ticket. So I flip them over. A little bit more Earl. Not much, so don't get crazy with the frickin' Earl. You'll be sorry when you put them on the grill. This is just to make the salt and pepper stick, pretty much. And then when I sear the hell out of them, come on, you can do it. I'm out of kernels. And like I said, the salt, it might seem like a lot, but that's a big piece of meat. And
it's a big piece of meat.
We're gonna be having sauce, Kraft chicken and rib, but not to the very end.
I'm sort of ready. I need to get some replacement parts for my grill. But we're gonna heat this up once again, get it hot. Those are cast iron grills. I always season them with oil a lot. That needs to go, but I don't cook anything up there anyway, so let it begin.
Also gonna have some of the famous spicy grilled corn. Let me find the spice layout. You guys can figure it out. I just upsize everything and mix a bunch in a big shaker, right? But she went dark on me. There you have it. This could work out just great.
We are smoking, searing hot. There's a Kiss song in there. Hot, hot, hotter than grill. You know you got a kebab coming. So, like from previous episodes, see the bone is in there. We're gonna put the bone to the back of the grill. And we're gonna sear the shit out of this for about a minute. And then we're going right to low heat. Alrighty, a little twist to get the nice grill marks. Sorry for the shit camera work. I'm battling flame here. Whoa, there you go. Another 30 seconds or so. Good night. Sweet. Now we go right to the lowest heat setting, and I'm going to do two-stage grilling because I want to really cook the shit out of that corn. And these are going to cook just like the chicken. Remember the chicken that cooked up from the bottom up? That's exactly what we're going to do here. It's going to be wonderful. I used to have a rack somewhere to do this, but what I do now is bounce that. Come on, you can do it. Something like that. I'll get it in a minute. Just like that. On edge. The bone on the bottom. Come on, mister. You can do it. There you are. And we're just gonna, that's super low heat. We're just going to let that go. See, you can't kill the meat because it's the bone at the bottom. And it's going to cook through. Oh, this is going to be so good. This was the thing I was looking for. Now I found it. So good. I totally overdosed on the spice last time. It's up to you. But I would start slow and finish hard, I guess would be the idea. Yeah, right. These tongs, I feel like the fucking robot from Lost in Space with like two useless claws that I couldn't even scratch my own ass with if I had to. Well, robots don't have an ass, so, well, I don't know. Well, the guy inside did have an ass, so I don't want to think about that. The other gag with the corn is don't forget the lime. It helps cool off the spice that's going to make you happy later. Safety warning. The corn will pop and spit juice in your melon. Maybe even in your eye. These are looking amazing. Time to start saucing. The problem I find with grilling food is that I've experienced the odors and smells and the sensations, and by the time I sit down to fucking eat it, sorry for my language, I've lost my appetite. But that's looking pretty skookum. Take those. Oh, back onto the bone side. Now we're gonna add some more sauce. Oh my goodness. Now I'm sort of working a little left-handed here, but that corn is grilled. Throw it on there. Boom. Ba-dump. Find my thing and butter and more butter, and then when you've had enough butter, add some more butter. Now the other thing that happened last time is this has like small holes, medium holes, big holes. I didn't look. I use the big holes. Sometimes you need a big hole. I don't know. It's about enough on that side. Give it a spin. More butter? What do you think? No. I think we've got enough butter on that to last us. There we go. I think that's enough spices. Now let's eat something. See? Always happens. Don't forget the lime. Don't forget the lime. I kind of think it needs more spice, but I'll regret it later. Oh, lime juice in the cuts in your fingers. My favorite. Thanks for hanging out, folks.
all the great links to things that could help a guy out are below. Big shout out to my patrons, Facebook group, subscribers, get a sticker, I don't know, have a barbecue, be happy, cheers. Oh, and be good to each other.